Forgive us our lateness. Master Chai, my congratulations on your appointment. By all accounts, you are a capable mayor.
Oh, I have capable friends, my lady. I must say, it's good to see you looking hale and whole again.
The credit for that lies with my own capable friend, without whom I might never have escaped my abductor.
That would explain why Elidibus has been fostering faith in the Warrior of Light. While you were enjoying your audience with the Wandering Heart of Zodiac, we were busy dispatching the last of the Black Master Essians, a task which proved almost insultingly easy. Formidable though we undoubtedly are, they were obviously sent to provide encouragement for budding heroes. One cannot help but wonder how many times the ploy has been used before.
Master Chai, you mentioned that the people of Colusia are similarly enamored of the Warrior of Light.
Indeed, though it's hardly surprising given the state of the world. Many are still struggling to find a purpose, and it's only natural that they should take comfort in the tales.
Then the fever has spread to every corner of Norvrent. We may have dealt with his black-masked minions, but it is plain Elidibus has yet to show his hand.
Oh my! What a spectacular sky!
Another star shower.
Wait, is that... Amarat?
Oh. Hear, feel, think.
Did you hear that? That voice calling out?
No, I didn't hear anything, but... Why do I feel so... like I've lost something dear to me?
Does Elidibus seek to awaken more people to the Echo with clearer visions of the final days?
Not of flesh and blood.
I know this magic. The rings are like unto those that the Exarch did employ in our summoning.
Are you saying the Exarch is summoning them?
Nay. yet the similarity can be no mere coincidence.
Should we make a stand here, or retreat to the Crystarium?
The ether churns around us. More of them will appear ere long. To stay would only place innocence in harm's way. We must fight this battle elsewhere.
Wait! Take one of our airships. You can decide what to do on your flight to the Crystarium.
You are a capable leader in your own right, Master Chai. The citizens of Yulmor chose well.
It's settled then.
To the airship! To something.
I think that's the last of them.
Apparently even they have limits. Nevertheless, we should remain vigilant.
Uriangée, something occurred to me while we were fighting. These enemies...
are heroes hailing from other shards, summoned hither to deliver this world from its doom. Scant moments after the star shower did they appear, as yet more souls were inspired to walk the hero's path, no doubt. Thus did hopes for salvation of realms near and far resonate and converge, lending still greater strength unto our adversary.
So that's Elidibus's game. But first things first. If the rings are the same as the Exarch's, then we need to ask him how that's possible.
The Crystarium is close. Let us press on.
They come.
So near and yet so far.
In the chaos of conflict, one can always find an opening to exploit.
Whoever taught you that is a wise man indeed, and good with a gun blade. But yes, I dare say we can create an opening wide enough for at least one of us to slip through. That being you, of course. Though others are welcome to follow in your wake. Reen and I will keep our guests occupied.
Brave and selfless as ever. Yet the two of you may struggle to fool our foes, etherically sensitive as they are. Had you a comrade who could use destructive magics to wreak havoc upon the ambient ether, on the other hand?
Very well. I too shall assist in the diversionary effort.
Oh, not this old dance again. Yes, obviously I'll stay and fight. Alphano, I'm about to do a great many stupid and reckless things. Watch my back, would you?
And there you have it. Take care of yourself, my friend.
We'll do our best.
Finished? Then let's begin.
Is done.
Oh, let me see, let me see! Oh, yes! Your memories are preserved safely within! We've done it! We've done it at last!
I have inspected the other vessels. They are all ready to receive of our friend's memories.
Oh, excellent! Excellent! I shall have my familiars bear word to them at once!
Elidibus.
It was not until I observed the battle between Emmet Selk and the Warrior of Darkness that I realized what I must do. I will summon heroes from other worlds unto the First, just as you did. Their presence shall serve to empower me, granting me the strength to crush my enemy.
Though it pains me to disappoint you, I feel compelled to explain that the magic in question requires no small amount of preparation.
Ah, but you assume I require my champions to be summoned in their entirety. I do not. Their souls needn't even be whole. My purpose requires no more than their burning desire to vanquish evil. This I shall sear upon the ether, raising thereby an army of phantom heroes to whom I shall whisper, as I have to so many over the ages. Here lies darkness. It must be destroyed.
And you expect me to cooperate?
I do not require your cooperation. Your death will suffice. The magic I shall have from your corpse.
Go, Lucas! We must flee!
What is this?
My friend, how did you... No matter, Elidibus, he took us unawares.
It was all we could do, to raise a wart to hinder his steps, and so we fled. But he took it, the vessel with the Exarch's memories. Forgive me, forgive me.
The vessel bears not only my memories, but my blood. The blood of Allegan royalty, granting him the means to control the tower. With it, he has performed I know not how many summonings, calling forth heroes from across the rift. And, as you can see, the burden upon the tower is beginning to tell. If you mean to face him alone, I will not allow it, not this time. Elidibus has exploited the people's nobility, twisted their purest intentions for terrible ends. And I cannot let it stand. As Exarch, it is my duty to protect them, to defend their hopes and dreams. So I am going to the Crystal Tower, with or without your blessing. Though, I would rather it were with. Thank you.
I joined you, but I would only be a burden. Better that I remain here with my gremlins.
I shall send help. Stay strong, my friend, and take heart. By binding Elidibus within the tower, we have done more than simply delay him. Much like our adversary, I am not wont to show my hand prematurely. But the time has come to bring my strongest card to bear. To the tower!